Hello guys, this is my PCXT 8088 setup. Which it's running a turbo mode, it runs at 10 MHz. And I have fitted it the CF card, compact flash card. And also a natty small wonder graphics solution. It's a CGA card. And previously I had a VGA card, but I don't have a CGA monitor, I have a VGA monitor. So I fit it in the cable and I bought this Chinese hardware that is supposed to connect a CGA to the VGA output. But on its own it had some problems. I think something with the color intensity, bit didn't work, and maybe some more problems, I don't know. And a friend has created a hardware hack on top of this hardware, which you can see here. I'll try to defocus so that you see his initial and his website. And this is finally give me, this kind of setup gives me an 8088 with a CGA graphics card working and displaying something on the screen. It's a bit blurry, so that I can try my entry for PC Jam. I created a small intro for PC Jam and tried to set up a weird mode with the CRTC. But I was testing it on VGA, and on VGA it was okay, but on CGA I much later found out that it would totally desync and show nothing. So I have a final version on my GitHub where I fix it, and I'm gonna show that to you now, among with other things. And yeah. Now I'm gonna show you some more 8088 with this CGA card. Actually, the first thing I'll do, and the reason I did it was to, let's see, that's the CGA display. It's not very. Let's try to run Norton Commander. Maybe adjust a bit so that we can. Everything. And I'm going to run my new entry, the final one. That's the final one that I made for the PC Jam. The one, if you go to the PC Jam competition, the one that is there is not the final one, but I have released it in GitHub, and I fixed some things. The one I was testing would run on VGA, but wouldn't even run on CGA. That's the CRTC syncing was wrong. I'm trying to set up the pseudo mode 160 by 50. Actually, I made it like 80 by 15, what you will see on the screen, so that it's faster on this computer. And the original setup mode was 100 lines vertical in the text mode using subcertic series. And so I changed the value to make it 50, but you have to change the other CRTC values to maintain 262 scan lines. I think it's 256 total, and there are 6 lines adjust in the other register, CTC ready, that says the sync adjust. Is it the vertical sync adjust? I don't remember. And just like on the Amstrad CPC, if you do things wrong. But emulators don't emulate this issues, they will show you things running normally. I don't know about PCM. Anyway, let's run it. Let's see my entry. And I tried to fix it before making the final. Now there are still few problems, but the scroller doesn't flicker anymore because I also in this mode the 50 lines vertically. My video RAM is 8K, so I can page flip with using the CRTC registers, the register 12 and 13, and just the 12, I think. Is it for the high byte of the start address? I can change it to flip between the two video buffers in this mode. The total CGA memory is 16 kilobyte, and in this mode this is 80 by 50 pixels what you see on the screen, but it's really using the character mode, the text mode of CGA, and with some CRTC trick grid using the character height to 4 lines. This way I can have 2 buffers, and it's better for this effect, for this computer. I could have done the 160 by 100, but the rotozoomer would be much slower, like 5 frames per second. This is running at 10 MHz. I'm gonna run it till the scroller ends. So this is the pseudo mode that you can have all the 16 colors of the CGA palette, which are like the ZX Spectrum colors, really. Because if you went to graphic mode 320 by 200, you would have 4 colors and maybe 2 or 4 limited palettes. You wouldn't be able to select any colors for the 4 colors. And that's it. That did 29 frames, close to 30 frames per second. And on 8088, 4.77 MHz, which I could do by removing the jumper, but I'm not doing it now. The jumper on the motherboard. I'll get almost 15 frames per second, and I know I can make it faster, but. And that was my entry. There is no music. I could show you few things. Here is an interesting entry, and I'm looking at Scully's blog where he fixes those entries. Here. And there is even source code here. This must be the fixed one. This is an old demo that would still have some issues with the raster bar and the scroller, I think, or not. And Scully have fixed it, and it's really. This is from the Code Blasters. And you see that, and you're like. Whoa, that doesn't look like CGA, that looks like CGA, but what is... the background colors are changed per line with a horizontal sync weight and change the palette color, but I thought CGA... In CGA, in this mode, 320 by 200, you had 4 colors and you could switch 4 colors with another 4 colors in the palette, but you could not have switch every color. There is an exception, the background color, the border color, which is mostly black behind, you can switch it with any of the 16 palettes. You can change the background color, I was reading about CGA on the 640 by 200, the high resolution, the same register will change the foreground color, it's the opposite. So in the high resolution, which is not this one, you have zero, the background is black and the foreground can be anything. But here you can change the background color, the color zero, from black to anything. So you can change it per line and do see all the CGA colors. But the foreground, the TCB logo is using the cyan and is it a red or a purple? Purple cyan, but it has a checkerboard to give the sense of a transparency. Cyan, white, but below here you have green and yellow. This is the second palette from the four colors, for the foreground colors. That is red, green. Actually, it was red, green, and brown, but there is the intensity bit to make it red, green, yellow. So this was quite nice retro demo for CGA. You'd think, okay, this is not CGA. And then I'm going to run just that new. This one is fixed. The original source code was that. And Scully would disassemble it. This was done for 8088 with CGA, but it wouldn't. If you try to run it on the real machine, actually, let's try. Whoa, 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 whoa. And now it crashed, it also crashed my keyboard. Sorry, I have to. This demo when it fails and I escape. I lost the focus a bit in the screen. Unfortunately. And the graphics on the CGA are a bit blurry. If I connected my VGA card, it would be much sharper. And let's see some CGA. I'm gonna see one or two from the competition. This one using the same 160 by 100 mode, but it's drawing, it's skipping some pixels. So technically, this is the number of pixels calculated for the rotozoomer are the same as my rotozoomer. Are exactly the same. It just works in the 160 by 100. It's skipping horizontally and vertically. It's skipping pixels, so that it has this dotted display. It also gets 30 frames, just like mine. And the original was that. Let's run the original. Laugh while you can, monkey boy. Because this runs at 9 frame per second on a true IBM PC running at 4.77 MHz. That was the slower version. 15 frames per second, half. I know a way to make it faster. Hopefully. Mine, that is at 30 frames on the 10 MHz but less accurate and with more pre-generated code. So there are some simple CGA. I'm running CGA stuff, CGA dots. You see some dots, sign dots. I don't know how many sign dots there are. It runs. I bet I can do it smoother, but I need to code. Are they 256 dots? Are they more? I haven't counted them. But okay. What else? Yeah, things like Paku in CGA. With Sound Blaster music. That's really cool. This is using the pseudo mode 160x100. I really like this mode. All 16 colors. You can use it as a frame buffer for effects. Even though in my Rotozoomer I used the Ah, crap. With all the CGA color. It doesn't look, it looks like CGA, but with thicker pixels. It's pretty easy to set up. And then you have to write every 2 bytes in the video RAM, starting from B801, after you fill the text with a certain character. You have to write a byte that is to background and foreground color, so every nibble is a color, is every pixel. But of course in my Rotozoomer, because that was these were too many pixels to make it fast on this computer. My Rotozoomer, I used the 80x50 pseudo mode. And this Magic Duck is the same. It's using the same mode. At least this is similar to my mode. How do I jump? Ah, okay. And you have the characters built like that, and then you have the regular characters, which
which you can change, or is it some? Can you change the fonts? Or do you have default fonts on CGA? I don't know. And finally, we will run another demo. Ah, the one that crashed us. This is from Genesis project, but we are going to run the final fixed version. And you see the screen is jumping, it's changing video mode. There is a bit of jump. I don't know if this is normal or is it the GPS hardware from the hack. So now, when this effect ends... Ah no, that's okay. That's on... I don't know which mode is that. The demo uses both 100 line modes and 50 modes. 160 by 180 by 50. And with various... And not even with solid pixels, with various text characters. Like in the plasma. And when it changed part, you saw a jump on the screen. This is because it's trying to set the other video mode. I don't know if this would be normal on a CGA card connected directly to the monitor instead of passing from this. Oh, it would be normal, maybe. Because I think this hardware, this extra hardware is doing the conversion to VGA, it's not... The RTC is in the card, I don't know. And it's the timing happens in the card. The output has nothing to do with that. I've seen this jump when on CPC you try to set up a different CRTC values. You see this temporary jump, and maybe usually you should turn the screen to black. You look great in CGA though. This is again the 160 by 100 mode. From what I see on the picture. It is not bad, it's... You could do some nice stuff. If there is enough time. Maybe in a 286. I tested all the stuff with my CGA. The Hornet demo 80088 corruption still crashes in the beginning at the same time. It has nothing. Maybe it has to do with the sound blaster. But the domination runs. The 88088 miles per hour. This is using the composite. I don't have a composite monitor or something, whatever. So, but when I ran it, some things were wrong, but some things were better, were much better than when I ran it with VGA. Everything was wrong, almost everything. With CGA, I partially could watch some of the stuff. The other problem I have, my PC speaker doesn't work, even if I have connected the speaker. Something is off on the motherboard, so there is no music. That's another. Oh, and actually, okay, I'm going to do something now. I will try to remove the jumper from the motherboard to make it run much slower, 4.77, because I want to see... Okay, I did it. Now it's much slower, you see it even when I... Now I'm running on 4.77. I want to see how my demo, after I implement the double buffering, how it looks, because I haven't, I have only seen on DOSBox. Now we are running the slower version. Still runs okay. The scroller doesn't flicker. I see a line in the scroller up. It's not visible. On the left side is wrong, of course. I don't properly. I'm not gonna bother with that. I don't properly correct the left side of the scroller. Because I was lazy and I had some kind of codes that unroll codes that would write only the font pixels that are not transparent and they will skip there. So I had to write different versions that would write only some columns or jump. Yeah, no. Nope, not now. I also have vSync enabled, to be honest. So if it's running a bit more than 15 frames, if it's running 20 frames, it would lock at 15, but I think it's 15. And now it's just 13. Actually, I'm going to press a button and remove the vSync. I forgot those buttons in the final release. The button is F. I think even if I press space, it's gonna try to run the other part, which is fail. Okay, that's on 4.77 megahertz. The double buffering is doing fine because I write the scroller later on top after finishing the call form. I do use a software buffer. I see sometimes something, some lines kicking of the scroller, but maybe it's not visible on the 14 frames, okay. And finally, what disappointed me is that, oh come on, GLX, the mod player, it doesn't display. I don't remember if it goes on VGA or... But I'm going to select a mod. Did I select a mod? Okay, wait. I put back the 10 megahertz. And that's it, guys. I need to close now. Maybe I'll try to do some more CGA programming. Maybe I'll set up a 286 for VGA programming. I don't know. I want to still try some CGA stuff. It's interesting what you can still do. Ah. Yeah. Does it run with it? Slower, of course. Let's let it run once more. This is at 10 MHz with the player in the background. So maybe if I had the batch file running the player with a lower frequency and doing my effects in front, I could have made a demo with music. The mod is from a really great 64K, believed by Valhalla. In the 90s, and I think, yeah, actually I tried, it's amazing, it has 3D effects, it has a big torch with cut by plasma effect, it has good combination of effects, a very glossy plasma behind with 3D in front, it's amazing then, for 64K, and really pumped out music, but it requires Gravis ultrasound, I think. I have seen it on my 486 PC, or no, on the Pentium 1 with Gravis ultrasound. I bought the Gravis ultrasound, and this is where the mod music is from. Scroller will restart now. Ten frames per second from 59:27. So this one took 1/3 of the frame rate, running at 22 kHz, as far as I remember. And that's it, guys. That was the video. Bye.